In the heart of the Gnarlwood, Talaxis, the Ravening Ruin, holds mysterious treasures from a crashed Seraphon Realmshaper engine ship. Many warbands have assailed these ruins in an attempt to gather these treasures and take them home, and Sigmar is aware of these plans and has sent forth his Questor Soulsworn to defend these ruins as well. However, the Royal Beastflayers have caught their scent, and now you can find out who the victor will be. I'm Adam Harry from Bowles, and this is Warcry Nightmare Quest. Warcry Nightmare Quest features two brand new warbands. You have the Stormcast Eternals of the Questor's Soulsworn and the Flesh Eater Court's Royal Beastflayers, which is kind of a ghoul cult with some new offal hounds, which are pretty gnarly looking. Inside the box is all of the rules you need to play these two warbands, as well as some additional terrain for the Gnarlwood set. What's really cool about the set is it also features the Realmshaper engine kit for the Seraphon, so if you just happen to be collecting those as well, you've got that kit in here too. So let's pop it open and take a look at all that cool plastic in the box. Alright folks, here is the front of the box, and real quick, here's the back. As I mentioned, all the stuff inside, Questor Soulsworn, Royal Beastflayers, new rules for games of Warcry, all the stuff you need to play the two warbands, and of course the terrain set. I really do like the Gnarlwood terrain set, and I like that they've incorporated a Realmshaper engine as part of this. Again, that's kind of the big beating heart of the Gnarlwood for this entire set for Warcry, this entire season. So it's cool stuff. So let's open this up. All right, plastic, lots of plastic. Let me pull out the sprues real quick because these are two brand new warbands. So we have the Stormcast Eternals here. That's one sprue for them. Here's a second sprue for them. I'll set them to the side. We've got the Royal Beastflayers here, which again, I believe this is the Flesh Eater Courts, of the ghouls. So that's one sprue for them. There might be another. Let me check. We have the terrain. So again, another really cool set of very large terrain. I really like the big chunky pieces that make good scatter terrain. And then the Realmshaper engine set mixed in here with some cool Gnarlwood bits. So if you have the other Realmshaper engine, this is going to be like a custom version. So that is very, having built a Realmshaper engine, I can say that this looks like it's going to be a different build. So that's kind of cool too. Let's see. And then more of the Gnarlwood terrain. We've probably seen some of this stuff before in the other kits. I can't recall exactly because it all does kind of look similar, but that's because it's supposed to. So you've got one, two, three pieces of Gnarlwood terrain, and then the Gnarlwood Realmshaper engine sprues too for terrain. So that's five sprues for that total. We do have the large sprue for the Royal Beastflayers, and then two sets of the three mini sprue, miniature, like medium-sized sprues for the Stormcast Eternals. And then there's more. We also have this nice little, that's a cool thing. I always want to frame these posters up. I think they look really cool. But they throw them in the boxes to protect the books and stuff from any kind of plastic poking them. So there's some cards. Yep, there's cards. You gotta have bases for all the stuff. And then the Might and Madness Warband Tome Book for the whole set. It's gonna include all the rules for the different warbands. And of course we have the cards too. And it looks like, let me go ahead and pop this open real quick. We also have the instruction book. Let's see, yep, there's all that cool stuff. And then the instruction book to assemble everything. So like I said, that's a really cool, the Realmshaper engine is kind of specific to this set. That's kind of a cool alternate version, I think. And then your warband cards for the two warbands. And then if you flip them over, you've got their special rules, kind of like a quick reference for you there if you roll doubles or triples or what have you. So for their special attacks. And of course you get a Warcry game board. I believe this is double-sided. And what's great about these is they stack, work together with any of the other versions, and you can kind of put them side by side. And if you get enough of them, you can cover a whole table and play big games of Age of Sigmar 2. So very nice. That's everything in the box. Let's take a closer look at all the different sprues. So kicking things off, I'm gonna take a look at the World Shaper engine. Having built the other version of the World Shaper engine, this is a different, completely different version of it. This one is geared towards the Gnarlwood set, which is why you have these extra bits that'll have extra vines and kind of that same look of the twisted trees kind of climbing up the sides with the various bamboo piping and stuff, the walkways going on. What's also cool about this is it's got on the very top of the plateau of this pyramid, it's got the little hole in the middle, and it's got this cool crystal bit that you can build that kind of comes out of the top, which I think is kind of what everybody's fighting over in the Gnarlwood anyway. Like, that's the big draw here, because the Realm Shaper engine's messing with things in the Gnarlwood. So I think if you're playing Seraphon, this is already worth your time. If you want to grab this kit, wouldn't grab it just for this, but if you collect Seraphon, this is like an added bonus if you were going to get the Nightmare Quest anyway. So assembly-wise, it looks the same as well. The one thing I am noticing is here that the previous Realm Shaper engine, the sides you could build either way, but this is... You can like flip them inside out and have a different style, either with or without the veins. This one is only with, vines, not veins. Or are they? You could, with this set, you're only gonna have the vines coming up the sides, and it's very, very jungle centric. So, but these are basically the same sprue. It's just how it's all built together. It's really cool. So that's those two sprues. And then again, real quick, the rest of the Gnarlwood terrain set. Here's two of those sprues you can see here. You get the bamboo ladders, you get the cool bone chunks from various animals that may have died and been kind of scavenged through. You get the cool creepy trees here, and again, more of the Realm Shaper engine chunks that you can use as scatter terrain. I really like this set as a whole, and I think if you have the previous Warcry sets for the Gnarlwood expansions, then this is another really cool terrain set to get your hands on. So those two sprues, and then finally, this one is probably, maybe, I don't know if this is my favorite over the world Realm Shaper engine, but I really like this big chunky bone piece here. I think that these type of terrains chunks, they're like, I'd call them like medium size, or they're bigger than small, they're not quite like full on large pieces, but they make really good table terrain for just scatter stuff. They make nice objective things to fight over, so I like this whole set. Next up, we have the Questor Soulsworn set. And if you take a look closely, these are the same sprues. So if you lay them on top of each other, you can see that they are the exact same. So I'm just gonna set this one to the side and focus on this one in particular. So what's great about this set is all of the different options. It's kind of nice actually that you get two versions or two copies of all of the different bits you can build. There are various weapons, kind of how you choose to equip your warband really will come down to your personal preference, but you can have, you know, different hammer options, different sword options. I know there's a duelist that has two hand weapon options and things like that, and those will impact how the warband actually functions when you're playing Warcry. Overall, this is neat because it's another cool looking Stormcast Eternal unit that you'll be able to add to a Stormcast Eternal army or Grand Alliance Order army if you want to. But yeah, it's just a cool alternate versions of some of the Stormcast, and these are the thinner Stormcast models. So they're not quite as big as some of the first edition, first versions of Stormcast. This is the sleeker, like Vanguard looking armor. So if you prefer the sleeker looking Stormcast, check out this warband for sure. And then finally, we have the Royal Beastflayers, again from the Flesh Eater Courts. I always like the Flesh Eater Courts because they have that air of authority of like we're the royalty and the knights of the undead, but we look like ghouls. So I always appreciated that kind of take on them. What's cool here is you have the royal Flame Master is one of like the key character here, and then they also have these new gnarly looking Ophel Hounds, which are these kind of they're all kind of bestial actually, but this is more like hound-like ghouls in a kind of a cool way. So I'm curious to see how this warband will translate to not only Age of Sigmar, but how they're going to play in Warcry by itself. But yeah, they're pretty cool looking. If you like the Flesh Eater Courts, this is another really cool looking warband to add to your collection. Furthermore, they're just gnarly. I don't know what else to say about them. They're cool looking ghouls, as cool as ghouls can be, I think. And yeah, just a cool looking warband to add to your collection. Well, that was our unboxing video for Warcry Nightmare Quest, and if you like Warcry, be sure to check out our other video on Sundered Fate right over here. I'm Adam from Bulls, thanks so much for watching, and we'll catch you next time.